section, fifth period.
Hello, Brownsburg High School. Thanks for watching BHS TV. Today's Friday, September 2nd. I'm Haley Stewart.
And I'm Bao Lu, and here's what's going on at BHS. The Best Buddy Club will have their match party on Tuesday, September 20. If you would like to join, please scan the QR code on the screen and complete the link by Thursday, September 15. Please see Ms. Comer or Mrs. Stephens for more information.
Freshmen, sophomores, and juniors, picture retake day is scheduled for Tuesday, September 13th. If you were unable to have your picture taken during registration, are a new student, or if you are choosing to have your picture retaken, please stop by your team office to make an appointment. Students choosing to have a retake done must return their photo order or proof to the photographer on the day of picture retakes. All students must have their photo taken by the photographer in order to appear in the yearbook, but you do not have to order a photo package.
It's not too late to sign up for a booth at the 2022 Culture Fair presented by the Leaders of Tomorrow. You have until today, Friday, at September 2nd at 3 p.m. if you would like to sign up. You can scan the QR code on the screen, which will take you to the Google form. Boards can be provided by participants. Slots are first come, first served. If you have any questions, please contact Marin Woods, Obeyemi Olofintui, or Cecilia Opoku.
The next Environmental Club meeting will take place on Thursday, September 8th, after school, in room B2, 428. They have exciting plans for this year, and everyone is welcome. Even if you missed their first meeting, they hope to see you there.
You can now pre-order the new homecoming merch. The design can be printed on t-shirt, hoodie, crew neck, and long sleeves. Scan the QR code to pre-order now. Clothing will be handed out Monday, September 19th. The game will be on Friday, the 23rd.
Hey, have you been to any of the boys' soccer games yet?
No, but BHSV Bolu Owolabi has some information on how their season is going so far.
First sport in full swing. The soccer team start off with a lot of energy.
My season's been fantastic so far. I've enjoyed every single second with it, with the new incoming freshmen.
Our season's been pretty good. We've been on a winning streak. We haven't lost yet, and we just got more to come. And we're always next. We're always up next for the battle.
My season's been great so far. You know, definitely looking good in that winning record, and you know, practices have been great, and looking optimistic for sectionals and having a winning season.
How have we improved from game one to now? I think just working together, knowing that it's going to be a process and we're just getting the reps in every single game, every single practice, and just working hard.
I definitely think the team chemistry and team bonding has been a lot better. You know, we're getting better as we go on. The, you know, play is getting improved, and, you know, just the team is just, we're getting stronger. You know, it's going to take a lot of effort, a lot of hard work and practices. We got to keep consistently doing well and, you know, just staying together as a team. And I think it should be no problem.
It looks like the team are working very hard to achieve their victory. Bolu Atifo Olabi, BHS TV.
Thanks, Bolu. I'm going to try and make sure to watch and cheer them on the next game.
Now it's time for sports. Hey, Claire, what do you have for us today?
Hey, guys. We've got a lot of teams in action the past couple of days, and it's been very exciting for our fall sports. Let's get things started with the Unified Flag football team who hosted Noblesville last night. The Dogs earned a 44-27 win over the Millers. Gavin Barnes had great defense in the game, and Casey Sparks recorded 3 interceptions. Jordan Clinity had his first touchdown of the season. The team will be back in action next week when they travel to Hamilton Heights. Good luck. The volleyball teams were back in action last night when they hosted Franklin Central. The varsity won in 3 straight sets and were dominant throughout. Haley Sullenberger led the team with 6 blocks and added 7 kills. Maddie Spence had 6 digs on the night and an ace. Nice job, ladies. The JV team won in 2 straight sets over the Flashes, 25-15 and 25-11. Sammy Clark had 5 kills and London Smith had 7 kills in the match. Nice job. The JV and varsity will travel to Plainfield on Wednesday. The freshman team also won in 2 straight sets, 25-16 and 25-15. Sophia Embeso was strong at the net with several kills and blocks. Tatum Hunt led the team in both aces and assists. Nice job. The freshmen will travel to Brebeuf on Tuesday. Good luck. The boys' tennis team was back on the court hosting Franklin Central last night. The Dogs got a 4-1 win over the Flashes. Sam Jodis and Drew Siniger teamed up on number one doubles for 6-1, 6-2 win. Nate Engel got his first win at the number one singles, 6-3-6-2. Hank Giles got his second win of the week, winning a number two singles. Sam Nelson made his varsity debut with Bryce Garland and won in a third set tiebreaker. Nice job. The guys will travel to Avon next Wednesday. Good luck. And both soccer teams have been in action since we last saw you. The boys hosted Tri-West last night and earned an impressive and dominant 9-1 win over the Bruins. Grant Porath and Roman Cordell had 2 goals each. Gavin Wagers, Luke Wickline, Weston Bradley, and Wesley Mbozo also scored on the night. Micah Aldridge scored his first varsity goal, and Drew Jennings and Kevin Young played their first varsity minutes. The varsity will travel to Avon on Tuesday. Good luck. The JV team defeated Tri-West 3-0. Will Doan had two goals for the Dogs, and Paul Wilburn scored on a header. Joey Wise kept a shutout and a goal. Congrats. The JV will host Lawrence Central next week. The girls traveled to Cathedral on Wednesday and came up just short of the Irish 2-0. Olivia Piercy had some solid midfield play, and Kirsten Tlukian played great from the back. The JV team got a 1-0 win over the Irish. Ariana Williams had a goal for the Dogs, and Parker Liddig got the assist. Ella Hansen had a shout-out. Both the JV and varsity will host Chesterton tomorrow. Good luck. And a good luck to the cross-country teams who will host the Bulldog Invitational tomorrow morning, and the football team who travels to Franklin Central tonight. And that's it for sports today. Back over to you.
Thanks, Claire. Now let's check in with Rose for a look at the weekend weather forecast.
Hey guys, we're going to see some varying weather this weekend in Brownsburg. Today, the high is 85 with a low of 66. Temperatures should be in the high 70s for the game tonight with no real threat of rain. On Saturday, the high is 82 with the clouds in the morning and about a 40% chance of scattered thunderstorms the rest of the day. On Sunday, the high is 77 with around a 55% chance of scattered thunderstorms starting in the morning and continuing all day long. Enjoy the long weekend. Back over to you.
Thanks, Ro. That's all I've got for you today, BHS. Thanks for watching.
Have a great weekend. Remember that there's no school on Monday due to Labor Day. We will see you next week.
And stay tuned for this week's football pump-up video.
And we just keep coming back again and again and again until we break every will that they have.
Six, one, two, three.
Go! Four, five, six. Hey. Hey.